And I did a video clip, several clips last week, on the chestnut oak and where it grows. And I actually found one that had been cut through by the trail crew in the Daniel Boone National Forest. So we got a good look at the inside of a white oak tree. And the white oak family, or white oak subgenus, those trees all have a similar colored heartwood. Well, just my luck today, I'm hiking along at a different park. I am not in chestnut oak habitat. I'm in good white oak habitat. There's lots of white oak in this park. This is in Jennings County, Indiana, and this is called the Cali Nature Preserve, C-A-L-L-I. Well-kept secret, because there's no signage indicating it's here. I found it on Google Maps, and Google Maps got me here. Other than that, it's probably a well-kept secret, and that may be just a good thing. Keep it from getting overused. But we have a large northern red oak tree here with the furrowed bark and deeper furrows than you'd find on a similarly sized pin oak. And we're not in scarlet oak habitat, so we don't have to worry about that being what this is. I'm certain this is a northern red oak. And what we've got here is the heartwood being exposed by this early winter sunlight. Unfortunately, I'm in my own shadow here, so let's try this and see if we can get this so it's not overexposed here. What we've got right here, you can see the grain of the heartwood and a little bit of sapwood right there, which is the lighter color, and then heartwood. So these are called red oak trees, and the pin oak would have the same color heartwood, the scarlet oak would, and several other species of oak that I haven't got to yet would have the same color, that light red, almost orangish color to the heartwood. So red oak trees in the red oak subgenus, or I call it the red oak family, have a similar characteristic of the color of the heartwood, and also most of their leaves have a bristled tip. There's probably a few exceptions like the shingle oak, but we'll just go with the generalization that most of them have a pointed tip on the end of the lobes, like this one right here, as opposed to rounded lobes, which, boy, let's see if I can get a, can't find a white oak right here. There's probably some pretty, here's one. So here's one from a white oak tree. Again, the white oak subgenus, or white oak group, tend to have rounded tips, and the red oak group tend to have the pointed tips. Now, this chinkapin oak here was not obeying either rule. It's got pointed tips, even though it should have rounded. It's in the white oak group. But there's a lot of variability in the leaves on chinkapin oaks. And they refuse to be categorized. I'll put it that way. But here we are looking at heartwood on a fallen red oak tree. This is a pretty large tree, so this one's been around a while.